Would you rather pay $650 or $66 for a smartphone? Simple. With the Appalachian Advantage plan, pay less upfront and then just a few dollars more every month. Better service, bigger savings. That's today's Appalachian Wireless.
Preparations are underway in Prestonsburg this afternoon as the city begins setting up for its annual Jenny Wiley Festival. We caught up with Mayor Les Stapleton early on Wednesday to find out more about the festivities they have planned for residents to enjoy this weekend.
Hey, it's that time of year. It's Jenny Wiley Festival. We're getting set up for it right now. You know, here Wednesdays when we always get started up, we'll have music tonight. It's getting set up. Right behind you is probably enough blooming onions to feed half of Prestonsburg, and we're excited about that. So, you know, we've got all kinds of things going on this weekend, and it's all going to end up with a Quiet Riot concert on Saturday night.
Mayor Stapleton also wants to let the community know that this year's festival is being planned to be as welcoming and inclusive as possible for everyone, especially children.
We have a peaceful sensory tent. It's for kids who need to relax, you know, just to be to get out of the lights, to get out of the sounds and everything, and relax for a minute. And we're going to have signs up pointing towards it. It's directly behind City Hall. And we've sort of got it out of the way so that they can relax. They can, you know, sometimes kids just get oversensitized, and we want to give them that opportunity to relax and give the parents an opportunity so they can stay here longer. And then, you know, on Saturday, we have a parade. We banned sirens many years ago. I think it's 4 or 5 years ago, because some of these kids can't stand the loud sounds, and we want everybody to enjoy this, and that's going to be our big thing, is we want everybody to be able to enjoy this festival.
Regarding COVID concerns, Stapleton is again urging residents to do their part during the festival to help ensure the health and safety of those in attendance.
We're going to offer, if you don't feel comfortable going without a mask, we're going to offer masks up at different areas. Just look around, you'll see them. We're going to ask people to social distance. We're going to have hand sanitizing stations everywhere you can be. We understand there's a virus, and we want people to be safe. We want people to take it upon themselves to do the social distancing, to recognize that some people have immune deficiencies and they need to wear a mask. And if they're wearing a mask, then you should definitely be respectful of them wearing a mask and give them some space.
For Mountaintop News, I'm Josh Sloan.